Well, Aaron, those giant waves are thought to have at least played a role, if not been the cause, in that local surfer's death. A sad end to a day surfers called epic.
You have surfers from all over the world that probably have flown into Monterey just to be here for this day, and it doesn't happen but once in a lifetime.
Amid the wild waves, a tragedy. A surfer, identified as 45-year-old Peter Davi of Monterey, found floating face down and unconscious in Stillwater Cove. Sheriff deputies say Davi is thought to have been paddling back to shore.
He had his board tethered to his ankle. That tether strap broke, and he was witnessed swimming towards shore. And then the people who were watching lost sight of him.
The surfer never made it in. Sheriffs say paramedics stayed in constant contact with a doctor at Community Hospital of the Monterey Peninsula.
We had CPR in progress on the guy, and he did not make it. He was pronounced dead here at the beach.
Friends from the surfing community pulled Davi to shore. Many more gathered after the rescue, visibly shaken at their sudden loss. Sheriff's deputies don't know how long Davi was floating in the ocean before he was found. Now, the resuscitation process went on for about a half an hour before paramedics and doctors went ahead and called it off.
All right, Brittany, thank you. Some surfers were actually towed out to the large waves by jet skis. It certainly gets them out to the larger waves, but it can also be dangerous. It is unclear at this point, though, whether Davi was one of those surfers being towed out.
Like their counterparts in Monterey County and Santa Cruz County, water rescue crews were on alert throughout the day. Rescue efforts began early this morning during high tide. An unidentified San Jose surfer was pulled out of the surf south of Capitola. Not seriously hurt, mild case of hypothermia, but it could have been worse.
Well, what he did right was he paddled back out and didn't try to go in, which would have put him in the cliff and bluff area full of rocks. It would have been a lot worse.
Several other calls for help late this afternoon. None of those incidents turned out to be very serious. High surf and large swells had barreled through Santa Cruz County, peaked early this morning with high tide, but a lot of people came out to get a glimpse of the weather roller coaster. For some along the coastline, this kind of weather just means sandbagging to be safe, too. Action News reporter Phil Gomez continues our team coverage from Santa Cruz.
Well, this is one of those high surf days along the Central Coast where there were few problems reported, but some folks put out sandbags just in case surf was actually pounding. From a distance, the 15 to 20 foot swells were something to watch.
I thought it was going to be a little bigger. We were hoping it was going to be a little bigger, but it's still beautiful, and I'm very happy to be here and see it. It's exciting.
Surfers took their chances, but Venetian Gardens homeowners in Capitola weren't taking any. Sandbags are in place just in case the ocean water flooded them.
Well, I mean, the tide's going to come in, and it's going to pretty much start. You can already see it's already starting to wash it all away, but hopefully we don't have to worry about it.
Usually when high surf strikes, the Capitola Esplanade gets the brunt of it, but not so today. It was business as usual for most restaurants.
Oh, there we go.
The Capitola Wharf wasn't a bad place to visit if you wanted to get up close to the surf. At the Wharf restaurant, you could actually feel and see the wave action at work.
It's unnerving to some. I've actually watched diners think they're getting seasick. But you know, if you work here long enough, it's kind of nice. It's like being on a boat almost.
While high tide came and went without any major incidents, it certainly left an impression.
You like them, Anthony?
Yeah.
You like those big waves? We're talking about riding them in someday.
Every once in a while, the surf would actually shoot up through the wooden planks out there on the wharf, but it was nothing like a couple of years ago when the surf was actually pounding over the end of the Capitola Wharf, man.
I remember the day you were out there. Yeah, I don't think anybody in Capitola forgets that. Thanks, Phil.